Hello class 8, how are you all? So today we are going to finish this chapter number 7, conservation of plants and animals. Yes, today we will finish it. Yeah, so our topic today, we will study some new topic like Project Tiger, Red Data Book, like this, endangered animals. You know, last time we studied about national park and many more topic. Yes, so let's revise them in 2 minutes. So what do you mean by national parks? National parks are area reserved for wildlife where they can freely use their habitats and natural resources. Yes, national park are the areas reserved for wildlife. Yes, they are reserved for wildlife. They can freely use their habitat and natural resources. Like Satpura National Park is the first reserve forest in India. Yes, Satpura National Park. Last time I gave you the question, write the name of any 3 national park. Yes, do you remember? So Satpura is the national park which is the first reserve forest in India. Okay, which is the first reserve forest in India, Satpura National Park. And we also studied about biosphere reserve. In biosphere reserve is a large area protected land for conservation of biodiversity and traditional life of tribals. Yes. And you know what is the meaning of biodiversity? The variety of plants, animals and microorganisms found in area. So we know that in Panchmadi biosphere reserve, it is consist of a national park which is Satpura National Park, which is the first reserve forest of India, and 2 wildlife sanctuary called Bori and Panchmadi. Yes, and we also studied about wildlife sanctuary. Wildlife sanctuary are the areas where animals are protected from any disturbance to them. Yes, any disturbance to them. So we studied about all these things. Yes, and we also studied about endemic species. Endemic species are those species of plants and animals found only in a particular area, not found anywhere else. Yes, like sal, wild mango found in Panchmadi, they are flora. And Indian giant squirrel, flying squirrel, bison, they are fauna. Yes, what do you mean by flora and fauna? Flora are plants found in particular area and fauna are animals found in particular area. So we studied about all these. Yes. Now new topic we are going to begin, that is Project Tiger. Yes, so Project Tiger was launched on 1st April 1973. Yes, why? To increase the population of Bengal tiger. Yes, because animals are very helpful to balance the ecosystem. We will also study about ecosystem, don't worry. So Project Tiger was launched on 1st of April 1973 by the government of India. Yes, by Indira Gandhi maybe. So the project aims at ensuring a viable population of Bengal tiger in their natural habitat. Yes, why did it launch? To ensure the enough population of Bengal tiger, because that time the Bengal tiger population was decreasing day by day. That's why it was launched, to protect them. So in their natural habitat, and also to protect them from extinction. Yes, protect them from extinction. Yes, extinction means lost. And preserving area of biological importance as a natural heritage. Yes, they are actually natural heritage. Yes, forever, because many foreigners comes in India to see Bengal tigers. Yes, from different countries they come in India to see. The diversity of ecosystem across the tigers distribution in the country. The project task force visualized these tiger reserve as breeding nuclei from which surplus animals would migrate to adjacent forest. Yeah. So which task force? Project task force. It do the work. They maintain the number of project, how many Bengal tiger are remaining in India, and they see that which new breeding are coming. Yes, which female tiger are breeding. So all the work is maintained by Project ASPO. So remember, kids, this date, it was launched on 1 April 1973. Why it was launched? Why was it launched? The reason behind it, the project aimed to ensure a viable population of Bengal tiger in their natural habitat, and also to protect them from extinction and preserving area of biological importance as a natural heritage forever. I hope that you understood the meaning. Now let's study about a new book. Yes, it is known as Red Data Book. Let's move on to the next point. So kids, let's study about Red Data Book. As you can see the picture of book, Red Data Book, you can see the picture. Yes, can you see the picture of Red Data Book? So what is Red Data Book? The book provides a central information source in the organization studies and monitoring programs on rare and endangered species on their habitats. Yes, it is regularly consulted when developing and implementing species measures for the protection and rehabilitation of such species. So what is Red Data Book? Red Data Book is the book which contains the information related to the plants and animals which are endangered. Yes, they are in danger situation, means they can extinct anytime. Yes, so the information related to those plants and animals are included in this book, Red Data Book. Yes, so this book provides a central information source in organization studies and monitoring programs on rare and endangered species. So by help of this book, we can monitor these kind of species. There are many species which are endangered. You know, kids, nowadays if you will see around you, you will not found crows. Yeah, the population of crows is decreasing day by day. The reason is same. So they are becoming endangered. So there are many animals, there are many species which are endangered. Yes, and also it includes the habitats. Okay, so it is regularly consulted when developing and implementing special measure. So there are many endangered animals, like if we talk about, and you know, dinosaur have already become extinct. Yes, dinosaur already extinct, and the reason is same, because of greed of human being population. But it is said that dinosaur was killed due to earthquake, flood, and somebody says that it was killed by ants. I don't know the reason. So it already extinct, and you know, snow bear, yes, which is in white color, found in snow area, it is also endangered animals. Yes, and if you know about gangetic whale, which found in Ganga River, which is also an endangered species. So all these are included in Red Data Book. Okay, so I hope you understood what is Red Data Book. Red Data Book is the book which contains the information about the plants and animals which are endangered or which are going to extinct. I hope you understood. Now let's study about the endangered animals. Okay, kids, now let's study about endangered animals. So What do you mean by endangered animals? Endangered animals are those animals whose number are diminishing and might face extinction. Yes, they can lost any time. Yes, their population is continuously decreasing day by day. You know, dinosaur is already extinct. Tigers are decreasing continuously. That's why Project Tiger was launched. Yes, tiger is one of the many animals. Tiger is one of the many animals which are slowly diminishing. To protect the tiger in our country, the government launched the Project Tiger to ensure the survival of tiger population. Yes, that's why it was launched. You know, when it was launched, on 1st of April 1973. Yes, so Project Tiger was launched on 1st of April 1973. So, Red Data Book, which contains the record of endangered animal, that's why we keep the record in Red Data Book. Yes, so we can know about all these animals species, we can protect them. As you can see in the picture of, you can see the picture of snow bear, which is actually endangered. You know, flora are found in particular area, fauna are also found in particular area. Yes, flora is referred to plants which are found in particular area, and fauna are animals which are found in particular area. So they protect from, they are found in particular area, they are endangered. Yes, flora and fauna are endangered, like wild mango is flora, it is endangered. And you know, if you know about squirrel, different kind of squirrel, Indian giant squirrel, yes, it is in endangered. It's true, many whales are endangered, many species of elephants are endangered. Yes, you know, there are many species, and flying squirrel, yeah, they all are endangered. There are many animals, it's true. So endangered animals are, their population is decreasing continuously. That's why government has made some laws to protect them. They made some laws. So I hope you understood what do you mean by endangered animals. Endangered animals are those animals whose number are diminishing and might face extinction. That's why Red Data Books are, which keeps the record of all endangered plants and animals. Yes, there are many plants. And for your kind information, let me tell you, many plants and many animals are already extinct. Yes, they are already extinct. They are not available on the earth because of deforestation, because of our greed. That is the reason. Or due to natural disaster, it is also the reason. Yeah, that's why it is said that a dinosaur destroyed due to the disaster. Maybe earthquake. I don't know the reason. Even nobody's. Okay. Now, let's talk about ecosystem. Let's move on to the next point. Okay, kids, so it's time to talk about ecosystem. Can you see the picture? Look the picture. First picture, you can see some trees and river, and in next you can see some fishes in the sea. So what is ecosystem? And ecosystem include all these things. So ecosystem include all these things. You know, in first picture, as you can see, stones, rivers, grass, trees, all. Yes, some of them are living, some of them are non-living. Water, you can see fishes in the water, you can see water is non-living, fishes are living. So ecosystem include all these things. So an ecosystem consist of living and non-living things, living and non-living things. Yes, which are the living things? Plants, animals, not only plants and animals, as well as microorganisms. Yes, those organisms which are very small. Yes, it includes everything, bacteria, virus, fungi. Yes, all these things, protozoa, they are included in ecosystem. So An ecosystem consists of all the plants, animals, and microorganisms living in an area, along with the non-living components like climate, water, soil, river, deltas. Yes, along with non-living components. Yes, in ecosystem, non-living things are also included. Which are non-living things? Water, soil, river, and climate deltas. Or their climate is also included. Yes. These all things form our ecosystem. Yes. Okay. These all things form our ecosystem. Please write down the definition of ecosystem. Yes. Please write down. I'm reading the definition slowly. Till then, you write down. An ecosystem consists of all the plants, animals, and microorganisms living in an area, along with non-living components like climate, water, soil, rivers, delta, that is. This is the definition of ecosystem. But we can make it short. We can do it short. In short, we can say ecosystem is a system consists of living and non-living. Yes, very short definition. Ecosystem made up of. Ecosystem is a system made up of living and non-living. Yeah, it's very easy. Yes. Now, let's study a new topic, migration. Let's move on to the next point. Okay, kids, let's study about migration. So, before we start migration, let me tell you one thing. You know, there are many birds, there are many animals, there are many insects. Or leaves on the earth. We have not seen. We know that they are in different color. Yes, they are in different color. So, I want to ask you a simple question to you. Kids, have you seen ever any colorful birds around you suddenly during winter season? Have you seen? Or during summer season, have you seen any colorful birds or animals around you suddenly? Yes, you might have seen. Yeah. Actually, they have come from the other country. Yes. Actually, India is the good place. India is a migratory place for different birds. Many birds and animals come in India. So, even fishes go move, they swim from one place to another, they migrate. Migration. So what is the migration? What do you mean by migration? Migration is the movement of animal from its own habitat to some other habitat for a particular time period. Yes, migration is the movement of animals from its own habitat to some other habitat for a particular time period. Yes, for a particular time period every year due to climatic change or for breeding. Yes, many animals in Rajasthan, they come in Rajasthan, in Chittorgarh. Yes, they come in many places of Rajasthan. Why do they come? They come due to climatic change, to adapt the change. Yes, to get the comfortable environment and for breeding purpose. Yes, to give the for the reproduction purpose they come in India. Yes, as you can see in the picture, have you ever seen these birds? Crane, can you see? You might have seen them. Yes. And they have come from very far, from the other country in India. These birds which fly very long distance to reach another land are called migratory birds. Yes. So migratory birds are those birds which fly a long distance. And you might have seen they fly in the sky in a group. Suddenly you have seen the shape, V-shape group of birds flying in the sky. Yes, yes, they fly together and you know, they do not forget the path. Yes, isn't it amazing? It is said that the travel according to the direction of sun, or they leave a smell. There are main reason. Yeah, they travel at night according to the star direction. So they do not forget the path. So migration is the movement of animal from its own habitat to some other habitat for a particular time period every year due to climate change and breeding. Okay, so there are many migratory place in India. You will find out which are the migratory place in India. You will find yourself. I hope that you understood. Now let's study a new topic, recycling of paper. Let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, you know why do we do deforestation? Because one more reason behind the deforestation is our all the notebooks, yes, copy books, they made all the pages made from the wood, yes, that we get by cutting the trees. That's why deforestation again. So we cut many trees to make papers, but you know, as you can see in the picture, whenever we complete our year, when we complete our class, if our notebook is half filled, we throw it away. So there is lot of waste of paper. Even newspaper, you know, every day publish newspaper in millions, trillions ton of newspaper publish in all over the world, uncountable newspaper publish all over the world. Yes, we read newspaper. So lot of newspaper waste goes waste. Yes, we need to throw it, but we can recycle it. Yes, we can reuse it, recycle it, yeah, using some chemicals. So our new topic is recycling of paper. So about 17 full grown trees are required to produce 1 ton of paper. Yeah, and every day lot of ton of paper is produced. And to make 1 ton of paper, 17 full trees are grown. Means think, now just think, how many trees do we cut every day? Papers can be recycled, yes, about 5 to 7 times for use. Yes, if we recycle them, we can use them again. That's why we should save, reuse, recycle paper to save not only trees but also to save the energy. Yes, it also save the energy, water, chemical use to make paper. Yes, if we recycle, we can save water, we can save chemical, yes, we can save the energy. Is it true? So we should use RRR method, triple R method, recycle, reused. This method we should use. Okay, so I hope you understood the meaning of recycling of paper. Why do we do recycling of paper? To save. Recycling of paper is done to save water, energy, chemicals. Okay, now last topic, let's discuss the last topic, reforestation. Let's move on the last topic. Okay kids, so reforestation, what do you mean by reforestation? Reforestation means again generating the forest. Yes, reforestation is the restocking of destroyed forest by planting new trees. Yes, reforestation is the method of planting new trees to generate the new forest. Yeah, reforestation is the method of planting new trees to generate the forest. We should plant at least as many trees as we cut. Yes, if you are cutting 2 trees, plant 4 trees. If you are cutting 6 trees, plant 12 trees. We have already caused a lot of damage to our forest. Yes, we already studied about the damage, what happens due to deforestation. Yes, we know that due to cutting the forest, global warming increase, lower of groundwater level, decrease in rainfall, desertification, flood, soil erosion and decrease in soil fertility, increase in the level of carbon dioxide, disturb the balance of nature. So many consequences occur due to deforestation. That's why we need to do reforestation. If we have to regain our green wealth, reforestation is the only option. Yes. If you really want to maintain the, if you really want to decrease the level of carbon dioxide, if you really want to make our environment green and wealthy, reforestation is the only option. We will have to grow more and more plants. Yes. So what is reforestation? Reforestation is the process of growing destroyed forest by planting new trees. Okay, that's why we should plant at least as many trees as we cut. We have already caused a lot of damage to our forest. If we have to regain our wealth, reforestation is the only option. I hope you understand. You understood all this. Now it's time to ask a question from you. Let's move on the last point. Okay, it's time to ask question from you. Question number one. Explain recycling of paper. Recycling of paper. About 17 full trees are grown, required to produce 1 ton of paper. Paper can be recycled about 5 to 7 times for use. We should save, reuse and recycle paper to save not only trees but also to save the energy, water, chemical used to make paper. Question number two. What is RRR? Yes, what do you mean by triple R? RRR means reuse, reduce, recycle. Yes, what is the meaning of triple R? Reduce, reuse, reduce, recycle. Yes, reuse, reduce, recycle. Yes, okay. And next question, define ecosystem and deforestation. Yes, what is reforestation? What is ecosystem? Reforestation means, reforestation is the process of growing the destroyed forest by planting new trees. Okay, we should plant at least as many trees as we cut. We have already caused a lot of damage. We know if we have to regain our green wealth, reforestation is the only option. And what do you mean by ecosystem? An ecosystem consists of living and non-living things. Yes, living things like plants, animal, microorganism, and non-living things like climate, water, soil, river, delta. So we can say that an ecosystem consists of all the plants, animals, microorganisms living in any area along with the non-living components like climate, water, soil, rivers, deltas, etc. Okay. Question number four. Write a short note on migration. Yes. So migration means, what do you mean by migration? Migration is the movement of animals. Migration is the movement of animals from its own habitat to some other habitat for a particular time period every year due to climatic change or for breeding. Yes, birds which fly a very long distance to reach another land are called migratory birds. So what's your work? You will solve this question, and one more question for you. You will find out which are the migratory place in Rajasthan and which are the migratory birds. Okay, this is your homework. Okay, I hope you understood. Now the chapter is over. Now we'll wait with a new chapter. Till then, bye bye.